welcome. You've got a friend. You're looking at him. Why? Because I make you play this beautiful piece, and let's go straight into it.
Thank you.
Welcome in my help section. You've got a friend, but you also have a piece to learn. And that is not your friend at the moment. What do we have? How many parts? We have the introduction, we have a verse, and we have a refrain, and then we have a verse again, refrain, and a BSC part, and then just refrain again. What you should do, first of all, is master the first verse and the first refrain and the C part. The other refrains and the second verse are variations. So the sheet music I've learned and I've seen so far does not have all the other variations that Carole King is singing. I did that. So you will be fine just learning intro, the verse, the refrain, and the C part, and then maybe the last refrain, because it has an ending. Okay? So we'll have a look at what helps you most here. You know there is a slow replay coming afterwards, so we can learn at your own speed. I will see what I can do for you, because it's a long piece, to help you in generally, and what could make your life easier, because that I was born for, to make everybody's life easier. First of all, it's the key. You probably even never heard about a key called A flat. Probably you don't even know there is a note called A flat. And I want to show you these chords first, because they will come back and they will have a very important meaning, because what makes a harder version, what's the difference between a harder version and a not so hard version, is that the melody is underpinned by chord notes. So instead of you playing this, you play. This is mostly the difference between hard and easy versions, that you have more chord notes to put under the melody note. And so it's really useful to know these chords. That makes reading from the YouTube video much easier. Let's have a look. So this is basically the A flat, the major chord. Well, the major triad, of course, then is the major chord, with major referring to the major seven, that is this one. So, but this is the A flat chord. And we have that in many, where there are just two inversions, like this one. So please learn these. They will help you learn the piece. Then we have also the A flat major chord, where I very often leave out the root but play something like this. You see how nice this sounds? Yes, so it sounds very nice if we just skip the root. And this is like this one, it would be the A flat, the regular triad, and so. And this we will have a lot. We will also have a lot the D flat chord. It's the basic position. And you learn these inversions. Also, we will have, just like on A flat, we will have the D flat major chord, that is this one. You see? Wonderful sound if we leave out the root and just play this one. We will also have, if the melody is this one here, we will have then this one. This is what I mean, what the advantage is if you know the chord. If you have the melody and D flat major, it's this one and this one. So you see the chord is often following the melody to make it richer. But the chord system below is always the same. Now we have this A flat chord. And what we also have a lot is then the A flat with the A flat bass with the D flat inversion over it. Remember that? It's just a D flat, but which you learned up front, and with the A flat. Then, regularly upcoming is this chord. So it's also good to learn this, have a look. You will remember it when you do the piece later. You will remember what you learned just now. It will be easier for you to find. What is this? I noted this for just readability as the E-flat 7. But in fact, it's much more. It's just more complicated to read. It's the E7. We have the 7 here. And then we have the 9 here. And the suspended or sustained, I don't know what sus is standing for, S-U-S. And the 5th. You see? So remember this also. The regular E7 would be this. You see the inversion. But this kind of boring sounding. So we have the the 7 here, the 9, and the sus4. You can also see this as the D flat chord over the root of E flat. You have the D flat chord over the root E flat, and then with the melody up here, the top note. And then we have this thing that is also regularly coming, so it's a help if I show you now these reoccurring incidents, moments, like or where else do I play it? Well, let's just stay with this one. We have this ba-dum-bam. What is this? It's the same chord here. Here, it is the B flat minor 7. The B flat chord, the minor chord, plus the 7 and the octave. So this the. If we now change the bass to the E flat, we don't have to change anything in the right hand because it's the same notes. Now we have the E7, 9, sus4, and 5. You see? Look again in the right hand, it's not doing anything. It's not changing. Okay. And also at one point I think it's where we just leave out the top note. So this is already a really good guideline for you to find the right notes from the bloody video. So let's have a look at the first verse. We're coming from the intro. And here we have this beautiful lead into the chorus, which then, into the verse, which then is F minor, and the F minor and C7 bit, these chords you know already. So we're coming from the G minor 7, which it has this beautiful voicing here with the 7, and the 4 on top. And then it starts just with F minor. And this one I took from the original. The bass is playing that. Doom, doom. So it's just going the C7. You see again we have the melody here and underpinned by the C7, which you see clearly here. F minor. It's the C7 just with the G in the bass. It's a common thing in pop music, have a different note in the bass. So it's C7 with G in the bass, and we clearly see the melody and the C7. Though knowing the chords helps you a lot. And here again, we have the F minor. C7, you see? And this one. If you would play this without the underpinning of the chords, it would sound much thinner. So in this version of You've Got a Friend, I went for the nice version with a lot of sound and didn't so much care about the beginners. I'm so sorry, but it's just a beauty here. I had to do it. So we have this, and now listen to this. It's just not the same then as a... which I also took from the original. We have again, we have the F minor, we have the C7, yes, it's a passing chord, I didn't note it, I didn't put it down. C7 here, just a little bit of C7 with the G in the bass, and then going up to F minor with the, just the bass is wandering up, but the chord you can see is still F minor. And then we have this, this might be kind of new to you, this 2-5 of A7, B minor 7. You see, knowing the chord helps. is the B minor 7 here. We just have the 5 here, the 7, and the minor 3rd of B minor 7. Again, skipping the root, you will find that a lot in the nice sounding pop piano tutorials like mine. Okay. Again, it's the E7, the melody is here, and I just put the... Now you see here, see, do you see the E flat chord here? See? It's completely there with just the melody on top. And here we are in A flat again. And we have the, again, the thing I showed you in the beginning. The D flat chord, just skipping, jumping around a little bit. And then we have the same voicings again here for the... And again, the melody here. We are again in C7 here. And melody. And we have again this little swap between F minor. You see? Again, F minor and C7. Again, I put the C7 notes, the 7 and the 3 under it. And so you see, almost be under each melody note, I have, well, it's not almost, but every second at least, I have chord notes. And we have this thing again with the F minor, the rest of the C7, just repeated as before, and the F minor again, the bass going up, but here's staying F minor. This is also repeating. Here we go with a lovely bridge to the and here we have this again, what I showed you in the beginning. You see, it was effective. We have this E7 with the suspended fourth here. What, just the voicing I showed you in the beginning. And then we have the D and going to the E, complete E flat 7. This is coming back a couple of times. Also remember that one, that is effective learning. You know, we Germans, we are effective tutorial robots, okay? And then we have this, the refrain. We have this one. And here I change the left hand. What pattern do I use in the left hand? It's very often, most of the time, it's I go between the root, the fifth, and either the octave or root 5 and the 9 of A flat, okay? You've seen this pattern in my tutorials, in my accompanying pattern tutorials also. It's a very popular pattern because it's, you see, it sounds quite rich and we cover a big span of the chord. That means volume, that's what we want. Not just in the hair, not just from the speakers, but in the sound of our tutorials. So, you see, I just do, keep it in mind and just remember the exceptions. So, now see what I do. Here, I told you before, just adding the major 7 because it's a typical interval here in this chord. We have to do it. Yeah. And again, left just the boring but rich sounding. Again, what do we have here? We have the D flat chord. And again, it's a D flat chord, but I just opt for the major 7 instead of the root. Now you've practiced the inversions. You know very well what it is. It's the D flat chord, and I just replace it, the root, with the major 7, and you see how much nicer it sounds. Okay, now comes a little moment I want to talk about. So, in a couple of sheet music, as far as I remember, I've seen a couple of versions that would just make this one. We are here now in, what bar is it actually? 21, 22, 23, 24. Bar number 24. It's the first chorus, first refrain, where we have Da da dum. Right at the beginning, and this melody, this I underpinned that with each of them with the, or almost like I played. Where was I? Okay. Yeah. So this is the luxury I put in there, which is not in easier versions. And then full chord again. You can at this moment, but only at this one. You can maybe, if you want to, skip just the middle added chords note, like instead of, you can, if that is too hard for you. Maybe only here. I wouldn't give up too much, but here it should be fine. Okay, now you see, melody, we are in A flat, and we are back to the chord, you see, just the chord underneath. Well, that's a lovely little fill from the original, just going briefly to the D. It's such a popular thing in pop music, just putting the subdominant a little, you know, D flat is the subdominant of A flat, and so we have a lot in pop music. It's everywhere from Elton John to Christian Fuchs, like, yeah, just nice and easy and easy. And then, and here we have the same. Here you can. Here you also regard it as a kind of similar moment here. It's in bar number 28 now. You can do, but here you have to be. Here you have to be single notes if you don't want to play or the chord notes. That's fine. You will feel it. Everybody can feel it, that it's not 100% necessary, but some are 100% necessary. Have it once, the chord, and have the next chord, definitely. Okay, and this chord, you know, it's the E flat 7 with a sus, just one octave higher. It's the same thing, okay? It's also the same then before. It's a D flat chord over E and resolving to the E7. Okay, let's have a look at the rest. Where am I? I'm lost. I cannot be lost, I'm a robot. I'm just pretending to be human, to be more likable, amiable. Oh, what's the word? See? Okay. Okay, now we have this. That, yeah, you can learn easy. Yeah. And I would appreciate if you play, because we want some energy here. We want some, she's singing energy there. And if we just play, we could just stare at wallpaper and it would be as intensive, okay? Like, again, we have the D major chord underlying major 7 and the 5. You see, there's a system in it. And here you have to jump quickly. And the octave, here you get your blast, you get your octave blast that you all want so much. And here again. Here we go, here we go, from the beginning, remember? Ah, D minor, B flat minor 7, can you see it? Take off your sunglasses and you might actually see it. Turn up the volume and you can hear it. And that's it, see? And this stays the same, it's a 7, E flat 7, 9, suspended 4th, and then. That is my help, because it is repeating. And the extra, if you want something extra,
It's really only when she said later things like... she didn't sing like that. That would be a car accident. You know, that are like really her little climaxes. If you want that luxury, learn it from the slow replay. And they're only, the rest is almost the same. It's just really these variations that you must learn on top. And the interlude is really, it's really easy. Do we have time? It's getting so long. I know that a tutorial that is too long is deterring students. They think, hey, wow, if they read 2.5 hours, if they see that in the description or like when they open the video, they just said, no, bugger off. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed it. And I see you in my next tutorial. Bye-bye from Berlin. Thank you.
hope you liked my video and that you learned something. Now you can subscribe. Just press this subscribe button or click on another of my videos on this side. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.